Once again, we're staying in our drawingmoreobjects.dwg file. And you can see I've left it in the same state as it was at the end of the last video. What I'd like you to do is double click on the wheel to zoom extents like so, and just unpin the draw panel if you haven't done so already, just so we've got a nice clean AutoCAD interface to work with. Now you'll remember that we created a layer called furniture previously in this chapter. Just go to your layer dropdown in the home tab on the ribbon in the layers panel, and just scroll down to the furniture layer there, click on the word furniture, and just make sure that furniture is your current drafting layer. We're then going to zoom in on this area here. So zoom in nice and tight, pan upwards a little bit like so, so that you can see this open space here. It relates to the 6858 dimension there between grids C and D, just so you're aware. We're going to take a look now at the ellipse command. Now, an ellipse has a major and minor axis, and as my son, when he was smaller, used to jokingly call them squished circles was the best way. And that's one of my favorite descriptions of an ellipse. It's a squished circle. It can also be a geometric circle rotated on an axis when you're working in isometric projection, which we're also going to cover in this chapter. But all I want to do is create a geometric ellipse that represents a table in our AutoCAD drawing. Now, this particular table over here, if you remember, was 3,500 by 1,500. I'm going to create a similar table here using similar dimensions, but the ellipse will have those dimensions rather than a rectangle like that one there. So let's have a look at that and see how that works. Go to the Home tab on the ribbon. Ellipses are in the draw panel. They're just here. Click on the flyout and you can see we've got center, axis end, and elliptical arc. Don't worry about elliptical arc. We'll cover that in the next video. But there are two types of ellipses available. You have center, where you specify the center point of the ellipse and then specify the major and minor axis. Or you can specify by axis, by specifying the lengths of each axis. I'm going to do that one there, which is axis end. So that works with the axes of the ellipse. You can see you specify 3 points, 1 to 2 creates one axis, and then you go up to 3 and create the third point, which gives you the other axis of your ellipse. So I'm going to click here like so and come into the drawing area. Now, I mentioned the table, the rectangular one. So I'm going to pick a point here, click once, and come vertically upwards like so. Now, that was our 3,500 dimension, remember, on the rectangular table. So 3,500, enter. So there's our ellipse there. Can you see it's now tied in to that height? There's the 3,500. Now, what I'm doing now, as I come out this way, can you see I'm specifying half of the other axis? So if that distance on the rectangular table was 1,500, we need an axis now of 750. We need to half it. And as you can see now, I've now got an elliptical table, like so, that is 3,500 that way, 1,500 that way. Let's do a quick measure to check that. So we go measure and distance. So I'll go from, let's say, the center there out to there. That's 750. So we know that that axis is 750 times 2, which is 1,500. We'll do another measure and another distance, and we'll come from the center here and come out to here. That's 1,750. So we know if we times that by 2, 3,500. I'll just exit that. So what we've got now is an elliptical table with the same axis dimensions as our rectangular table. So all I've done there is use the same dimensions, but with an ellipse. And you can see the geometric ellipse that we've created there. I could have done that using the center settings as well for an ellipse. And all I would have done there is specified half of each axis. So I would have done 1750 and 750 to generate the same geometric ellipse. So you can see how ellipses can be used very quickly and easily in your drawing to represent geometric shapes. In this case, a table in one of the rooms in our floor plan.